comes on basis of social stratification, and that is caste, class, gender, age, and qualification. So based on gender, we classify the society as male, female, and transgender. And based on age, we can classify them like people, students, adolescents, adulthood, and then people, small children. We can divide them into different age groups. And education, qualification, we can classify them on the basis of qualification, like illiterate, literate, graduates, those people who have submitted their, who's completed their 12th standard like that. So we can classify them, stratify them on the basis of their qualification. So next we'll see what is the role, what are the problems of social stratification. So when we are stratifying the people, there are certain restrictions that people cannot move from one stage to other stages. There are some people who privileged people who enjoy all the benefits, and there are people who are underprivileged who cannot enjoy the privileges. So there are, because of stratification, there are some restrictions are there in the society where people cannot enjoy the privileges or the usual systems the government giving them, giving whatever the government is giving, cannot enjoy them. So social stratification is, sometimes it is good. For example, when the government forms some policies, frame some policies or scholarships like that, it is easy for the government to frame policies so that people can benefit from the policies. And there are sometimes when people cannot benefit from the government because of stratification. So social stratification, sometimes it is good, sometimes it is bad. And then the role of education in social stratification. So for example, the education plays an important role in stratification. For example, the people who belong to the caste system, people who are very low in their caste system, low category in the caste system, hierarchy or order, they are low people. And those people, when they are getting education, they become in the caste system, they go to higher class. For example, when they see NC child who gets education, because of stratification, government gives some scholarships, some benefits. Using that benefits, the child gets education. After getting education, he reaches a higher position in the in any office. So he becomes economically, he goes to higher class system. Okay. So social stratification is, there are different types. One is closed type, and another one is open type, where people move from one place, one stratification, one strata, or one category to other category. Okay. So education plays an important role in social stratification. So today we saw what is social stratification, the meaning of social stratification. So social stratification means division of a people or a society or a group into different groups and placing them in a hierarchy, into categories, and placing them in a hierarchy is called social stratification. And we saw two definitions of social stratification and the different forms and basis of social stratification, how we classify the society, on what basis we classify or stratify or divide the society into different groups. Okay, so that is based on caste, based on the class, gender, age, qualification, and we can say we can stratify into many different types. Okay, and how education plays an important role in stratification. What is the importance of stratification is also through stratification, government, it is easy for the government to plan some scholarships or some policies. It will help the people who are marginalized, who are very poor, who are under poverty, and it helps them to come up with their life. Okay. Thank you, because we'll see other topics in the next video. Thank you.